Hi, I'm Chef Ted. I'm coming from the Rada Cutlery Kitchen, and today I'm going to show you how to make a pepperjack chicken roll. We're going to sauteing up some asparagus. I'm just going to put them in a pan, put in a stick of butter, and then I'm going to take my Rada Chef, and we're going to julienne cut a sweet onion. And on these, I like to cut them in half. And then I adjust the angle of my knife with the angle of the onion as it comes around. And we will get those in. Add in some pretty colorful peppers. Got a yellow pepper, a red pepper, and some green peppers. And then I like using the peeling paring knife to go through and get the white membrane out. Has a little bitter flavor to it, and it's not the color that we're looking for. So we just clean those up. And then I'm just going to julienne these as well. Right now the onions and the asparagus are in the butter and olive oil, and that's also creating a little bit of a sauce that's going to go in with the chicken breast after we get them all put together. These can be done with the standard paring knife just as easy just by doing this if you don't want to use the big knife. There we go. Also use the Rada cook's knife, which is a Santuco design. It's a really handy, really comfortable knife to use. And these are things that you can get through fundraisers as well. If you've got a group or organization that needs fundraising, Rada has a great program for it that it pays out better than any other fundraiser I've ever seen. The Rada program pays out at 40%, goes to the group doing the fundraising. And I'm gonna stir it around a little bit with the Rada spatula to bring out the flavors. A little bit of sugar in there. Caramelize a little faster for me. Try to get the vegetables nice and translucent. But now I'm going to open up some chicken breast. A chicken breast like this is going to serve possibly two or three people, depending on how you fillet it out. I'm going to use one of the Rada outdoor knives, the fillet knife. A little tendon in there usually, get that out of there. This knife just walks right through it. What I like to do is I like to take it from the thin side and cut it towards the thick side. So I'm laying it open like a book. Not all the way through, just so it's laid open about like that. And right now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take some thin cut slices of ham, and I'm basically going to be making what I call a cartridge to load into the chicken breast, and just a couple pieces for basically you're aiming at whatever size the width of the chicken breast is. That's how wide you want your ham strips to be. You just want to cook them down so that you can tell that everything's starting to get good and tender, because the asparagus will be finishing off inside the chicken roll when it gets to that point. All right, and I'm going to bring over the sauteed veggies and try to shake off at least a little bit of the butter and oil so that they're not overly juicy. Right now I'm going to use the Rada cheese knife, and I'm going to cut up some pepper jack cheese. I like the stuff a little spicier. Of course, you know, once again, it's totally personal taste. If you don't like it as spicy, you can get a mild, or you can do it without using pepper jack. We're going to roll these back up here. Drop them into the chicken. Like so. Fill these in. Then I'm going to continue rolling the chicken breasts up. Let them sit where they join, where the seam is. Try to keep everything inside as much as possible. And these will feed two or three people. I'm gonna take a little seasoned salt. You can use salt, pepper, use a little garlic, whatever you want to use on yours. This is the one I prefer. Put just a little bit over the top of it. We're going to pick these up carefully and place them into the rectangular Rada stoneware pan. Now I'm going to take the butter and olive oil and juices off those sauteed vegetables that we've reserved, and I'm going to pour them over the top of and in with the chicken rolls here. This is going to be part of the base of the sauce. Of course, I always like throwing in any of the leftovers if you're not making a whole bunch of them. Also throw in just a little bit of white wine if you care. Going to put a little more seasoned salt on top of it. And we're going to put those in the oven at 350 degrees until they reach an internal temperature of 165 degrees. All right, we're using really, really large chicken breasts for the Pepperjack chicken rolls today. So it took a solid 45 minutes in the oven. At about half hour in, I opened it up and I put some more slices of the Pepperjack chicken on top of it, which browned up really, really nice. So for plating, what I'm going to do is I'm going to get some of the extra veggies that I put in alongside, and I'm going to drop them out here on the platter. Then you'll definitely want to wait and let your chicken rolls rest for a little bit before you try slicing them. And the chicken roll comes right out of the Rada rectangular stoneware pan, and there is absolutely nothing stuck on the bottom whatsoever. All right, we've got it sliced, and now I'm just gonna garnish it up with a little bit of grilled asparagus. And there you have the Pepperjack chicken roll.